never know who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to love you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before the legend ever did. Was that Marilyn was found in the news. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to know you, but I was just a kid. The candle burned out long before the legend ever did. More than just our Marilyn Monroe. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in.
My dear godmother, my Aunt Janice, loving you was always incredibly easy because you embodied all the wonderful qualities the best amongst us do. Your caring, quiet confidence was evident in everything you did. Having a conversation with you was refreshing, as you were such a great listener. I was told you could be quite feisty. Luckily, I never had to experience that. I guess what is said about the quiet ones is true. My mom will miss those daily calls so much. I think it kept both of you going. You can never forget your smile. I am thankful that the two of you were able to spend those precious last few weeks together. Shakila and Ashia, I hope you know my mom will be calling you still, and then she still, if you two don't answer. Imari, when you get your phone, don't give Granty your number, okay? Shakila, Shistel, Ashkia, and Imari, your mom, your grandmom, is always going to be with you through the love you feel for her. So keep her safe in your hearts. Aunt Janice was proud of all of you and loved you with all her heart. I am proud of how you cared for her, and I love you. Aunt Janice, my belief is that we reunite with our loved ones. So please give Passid and Double D a huge hug for me. Until we meet again, my beautiful Auntie Janice, I'll keep you alive in my heart. Rest well.
Like a sunflower that follows every movement of the sun, so I turn towards you to follow you, my God. The sun sets every day in our lives. Until that day, we no longer rise. On the 13th of August, 2021, the sun set for my dearest Auntie Janice. Her earthly journey was over. No more pain, suffering, and discomfort. This is the only thing that helps me come to terms with such a loss, for she was a very special person in my life. Auntie Janice can be summed up using four simple words: loving, kind, caring, and selfless. These are four priceless qualities, all of which she truly possessed. Auntie Janice was more than an aunt to me, as she treated me more like a daughter. My first memories of her are from the tender age of 5. She had just returned from England, where her nursing career started. I still to this day remember that smile on her face as she opened her arms to hug me. This same smile was seen on my last video call with her a few days before she left us. I will definitely miss this contagious, beautiful smile, along with her listening ears, patience, and loving ways. She had a heart of gold, which she shared evenly with everyone who was lucky enough to know her. Auntie Janice taught me to do many different things, such as tying my shoelaces, crocheting, and even using cutlery in the correct manner, as I am left-handed like herself. I think I even moved on the netball court like her, even though I was never as great a player as she was. I can still hear the words, "Nice, nice, nice," from the supporters before she would accurately throw the ball straight through the net. She was indeed a fantastic netball player, right up there with all the greatest players ever known. Yes, this was my Auntie Janice. Today, I am sadly not here in person to say a proper goodbye, as I would have loved to. But I find comfort knowing we both always told each other how much we loved one another up until a few days before her passing. I am very happy she got to spend the time she did with her sister Merle, who I'm lucky to call my mother, for I know how special this time bonding would have been for them both. My mom has not only lost her sister, but her childhood best friend. Mommy, keep strong, for that's exactly what she would want you to do, especially for her children and grandson, Imari, who she loved dearly. I love you, Mommy, and I am sorry I could not be here with you today. To Shako, Shis, Anash, I admire the love and care you gave to your mother up until her last day. I promise I will, as best as I can, always be here for you. It is a promise I made to your mom as the big cousin and sister that she made me to you all. I am so sorry I could not be with you today in person, but I am in my heart. God bless you all, always. I am sending my strength, love, and prayers to you, her children, her grandson, her best friend and sister Merle, and to the rest of the Martial family. Auntie Janice, your sun has set now, but your memories will live in my heart forever. Sleep peacefully, my loving Auntie Janice, until we meet again. Your shoes and socks, your niece Shura. Big kisses.
What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. without one plea, but that thy blood was shed for me, and that thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come, I come. Just as I am, though tossed about with many a conflict, many a doubt, fightings and fears within, without, O Lamb of God, I come, I come.
Then sings my soul, my
my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, when Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou
me say if only we believe.
Thank you for the poem, our eulogist, Lucia Mul Dilipni.
Bear with me, because it's really hard for me. It's the hardest thing I've ever had. Thank you. Eulogy for Angela Janice Martial. Angela Janice Martial, affectionately referred to as Jan by her siblings, and Jano by others, was the fourth child born to Sydney and Hamilton Martial on the 20th of September, 1946. He was welcomed into her family, who at the time resided in Souffre. Angela attended the Souffre Infant School and later transferred to the Ave Maria Girls Primary School as the family moved to Castries to accommodate secondary education for the other siblings. She had 12 siblings, Augustine Gale, Clement Delbert Martial, Mary Brenda Martial, Lucia Merle, Harrison Chari, Paul Edwards, Leonie Emil, Marianne Mottwood. Other siblings predeceased were Stephen Martial, Elvin Martial, Marjorie Questel, and Sandra Holbein. The family moved from the CDC where they initially lived, 71 Brussels Street, where the siblings were raised to be respectful, kind and loving. Angela Janice embraced all those qualities and carried them under her calm demeanor. She later attended the St. Joseph Convent to further her education. Janice loved sweets and always saved her coins to buy ice cream and creamsicles on the way home from St. Joseph's Convent. Janice later took up nursing in the United Kingdom, and after graduating, returned to St. Lucia and was employed at Victoria Hospital from 1974 to 2001. Her passion for nursing showed during these years as she cared for many, having a special compassion for the elderly, and took extra care in nurturing nursing students. A trip to town, which would normally take 20 minutes, would take over an hour if you went with Nurse Martial, aka Nurse Knight. Every few steps you took would result with a former patient or their family member who would express how great she treated them and how thankful they were. Janice nurtured three children of her own, Aisha, Estelle, and Ashley Martial. She raised them as sisters, teaching them the same values as a child. She taught them strength, unity, the importance of education, kindness, and most of all, love. Her only grandson, Mary Martial, a daughter. He would not go a day without sharing a good memory with his grandmother. Her godchildren, Mohammed Delikni and Jiri Martial Leopoldi, received guidance from her as she taught them to love the Lord like she did. Also had a very good relationship with her nieces and nephews, who adored her just the same and would constantly shower her with love, especially her Shura, Glenel, Cher, Ansha, Sonia, Marlon, Aaron, to name a few, by everyone. In 2001, she retired as a nurse, but still returned to Victoria Hospital to work sessions until she was diagnosed with Parkinson's in 2008. Her children immediately adopted her nursing trait to care for her in the most diligent manner. It was there that the unconditional love she taught them was returned to her. Like a typical Martial, Janice was fascinated with sport. She was well known as a goal shoot for the Shamrock Sports Club said Russia national netball team and the old girls national netball tournament. Rano also enjoyed watching basket. Her hobbies included baking, cooking, crocheting, singing, dancing, and shopping. She made a delicious milk punch, which her nieces and nephews always requested for travel. She had a love for fashion and was deemed the fashion of the family. Janice enjoyed the revelry of carnival and travel. She would visit her sisters in Florida, Canada, and Jamaica as often as she could. On her trips to Florida, she particularly enjoyed going shopping with her niece, Dusty. She looked forward to her daily video calls from her sisters and particularly enjoyed the Monday, Wednesday, and Friday spiritual devotions with her elder sister, Dusty. She also enjoyed her calls and visits from her dear friend, Catherine As, who would check on her regularly. She held her monthly communion mass. Though her Parkinson's progressed, Rano remained the heart of the family and always grateful for the support received not only from her children and family, but also from the persons in her community, particularly her neighbor, Jessie Dalso, would visit her regularly. Who visited them. You see the rose in Jano, which Jano loves so much. Jano particularly enjoys spending time with her caretaker, Janet Sophia Samia, who spoils her with treats. Janice died as she lived quietly and peacefully. She will definitely be missed by those who adore her, but her memory will live on through her family. Thank you, everyone. Thank you to everyone who continued to show her love and appreciation during her life, and may her soul rest in perfect wisdom in her heavenly Father's arms. Thank you. Sorry for the mistakes.
seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to love you, but I was just a kid. The candle burned out long before the legend ever did. Was that Marilyn was found in the news. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle wind.
Blessed upon you, our sister Angela Janice, with the holy water that involves the baptism, of which St. Paul writes, all of us who are baptized into Christ Jesus, who are baptized into his death. The baptism into his death, we will bury together with him, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live a new life. For if we have been united with him by the blessed of his death, so shall we be united with him by the blessed of his resurrection. On the day of baptism, Angela put on Christ, the day of Christ's coming, we should be clothed with glory.
Maybe quite As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Angela Janice, we beseech your mercy that she who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For even though by our own fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, when seized by death according to our sins, we are redeemed through Christ's great victory, and with him called back into life. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end, we acclaim. Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Robert our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Angela Janice, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We stand.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy
I should enter under my roof,
but
only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please sit. Persons may come up for communion as we sing, Come Let's Share.
Come
stand for the post-communion prayer.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our sister Angela Janice may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated. We shall now have the signing of the registers, and I invite the four witnesses to join me at the table: Daisha Marshall, Christelle Marshall, Askiok Marshall, and Lucia Merle Deligny. And we listen to a special rendition, the Latin Ave Maria. Shall we stand up for the final commendation?
Before we go our separate ways, let's take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself.
All I ask of you.
All I ask of you.
arms, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Hasten to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Angela Janice, your servant. In the sight of this world, she is now dead. In your sight, may she live forever. Forgive whatever sins she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Angela, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And when Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
A gentle reminder, please pick up all your belongings, your keys, your bags, your cell phones, and the reefs. As we take our sister, my friend, to her resting place, our recessional hymn, I'll See the Mother Dear.
Cemeteries, so let us pray. our sister Angela Janice has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven with faith and hope in eternal life. Let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant, Angela Janice. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. As her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need, and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord.
And let perpetual light shine upon her.
May she rest in peace.
Amen.
May her soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, for the mercy of God, rest in peace.
Amen.
May the love of God and the peace of the Lord Jesus Christ bless and console us, and gently wipe every tear from our eyes. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.
I wish to apologize for the technical glitch at the signing of the register. The family of Angela Janice Martial wishes to acknowledge with deep appreciation the many expressions of love, concern, and kindness shown to them during this time of bereavement, and thank you most sincerely for attending our sister's funeral mass.
by no home gene. No, I never knew you at all. You had the grace to hold yourself with those around you. Crawled out of the woodwork and they whispered into your brain. They set you on the treadmill and they made you change your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. I would have liked to know you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before the legend ever did. That Marilyn was found in the news. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to know you, but I was just a kid. The candle burned out long before the legend ever did. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would like to know you, but I was just a kid. The candle burned out long before the legend ever did.
Like a sunflower that follows a-
Goodbye, no Homer Jean. No, I never knew you at all. You had the grace to hold yourself with those around you. Crawled out of the woodwork and they whispered into your brain. They set you on the treadmill and they made you change your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to know you, but I was just a kid. You can
God ever did. Was that Marilyn was found in the news. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in.
Sins and griefs to bear, and what a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. I come to garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. Talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever. I'd stay in the garden with him
of the night around me is falling, but he bids me go through the voice of hope. His voice to me is calling, and he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.
Promise I believe, O Lamb. Safe from wrath,
to the cross I cling. They could come to thee for dress, helpless, low to thee for grace. Foul I to thee, fountain fly, wash me,
Lord, to thee, how great thou art, how joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior, Lord, to thee. How great thou art, how great.
One day at a time, Jesus, that's all I'm asking from you. and tomorrow may never be night. Oh, me away on the
Thank you. Open it there. Open it there.
Thank you. What are you doing?
Bueno.
Déjelo acá. ¿Está aquí? ¿Cómo? 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 ¿Cómo?
I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread, you shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up.
Sanctuary for
prepare me.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary.
Yeah.
I'm just a man. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am.
On the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love,
a sign from above.
On the wings of a dove, when troubles surround us, when evils come, the body grows weak, the spirit grows numb. When these things beset us, he doesn't forget us. He sends down his love on the wings of a dove. On the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love,
a sign from above.
A dove. When Noah had drifted on the flood many days, he searched for land in various ways. Troubles he had some, but wasn't forgotten. He sent him his love on the wings of a dove. On the wings of a snow white dove, he sends his pure sweet love,
a sign from above.
On the wings of a dove, on the wings of a snow white dove,
a sign from above.
On the wings of a dove,
a sign from above.
On the wings of a dove.
Hallowed be thy name.
find your home again. No, I never knew you at all. You had the grace to hold yourself with those around you. Crawled out of the woodwork and they whispered into your brain. They set you on the treadmill and they made you change your name. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. I would have liked to know you, but I was just a kid. Your candle burned out long before the legend ever did. That Marilyn was found in the news. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would have liked to love you, but I was just a kid. The candle burned out long before the legend ever did. And it seems to me you lived your life like a candle in the wind, never knowing who to cling to when the rain set in. And I would like to love you, but I was just a kid. The candle burned out long before the legend ever did. Candle burned out long before the legend ever did.